Okay, so good evening. Just sort of do this video as an idea I had for a little while, because I usually introduce, in a way, my instruments that I use in the videos we do. I did it with my, you can't really see them, but over in that direction is my my ukulele, and my mandolin stuck away in the corner in its case. I haven't used that for a while. And any other say, guitars or anything that I use. I never really did one for my drum kit, which I've used for a few videos now. It's my electronic drum kit. It's a, what is this damn thing? TD-6V, a Roland TD-6V drum kit, electronic drum kit. V drums, I guess they call them. I quite like them. They're pretty good fun. They're good. When I got it a few years ago, I guess I was probably a lot more impressed with it than I am now, because since then, I've played a few real kits, and it's a very different sort of thing to play on a real kit with someone, like in a band, as opposed to the electronic one. I've got it hooked up to a friend's PA system that I've got in my room that I have to get back to them. Why I'm doing a rush job of it now, but it sounds okay. It's not bad, you know. This is just a general rock kit. It's the one that I use all the time, actually. It's called Rocket. I could end up with my father coming here and telling me to shut up a minute. Oh well.
Yeah, boy, what are you doing?
I've always enjoyed playing the drums. I love playing the drums, and I love playing these things. They are good fun. I've got these rubber pads. There's only one mesh pad. It's basically a very fine mesh that's designed to feel like a drum skin. I'll point that out in a minute. That's on the only one on that is a snare. This is kind of, I bought this back in 2006, I think. And because I wanted to get back into playing the drums, because I hadn't played them for years, and I always loved playing them. It's basically a five-piece kit that plays nice. I'll actually show you the interface in a minute, just for something to do. Can get a little bit hard on the wrist sometimes, and the sounds are okay to practice with, and I even put them through live gigs through piano. I guess they sound okay, but they do sound, the way this drum brain and the sounds in it work, it does sound a bit MIDI-ish or fake. It's not as nice as the higher end models. The higher end models are lovely, the ones with all the mesh heads and stuff, and the bigger rack, and they look more like real drums, and they've got much, much better quality sounds on them and stuff. This one was kind of medium range when I bought it. It'd now be one of the lower range kits, if they actually still make this particular one at all. They make one similar to it, but I think it has all mesh heads now. That might be the TD-7 or something. Yeah, I'd absolutely love the TD-20, but I'm never going to ever get that, because I just can't sideline, anywhere from 10 to 15 grand, depending on where you buy it for an instrument that's, be something I'd just be playing at home for fun, and it's not going to make me any money by playing live. And if I was going to be playing live regularly on drums again, I'd probably go for a real kit again, which I don't have the room for. You can probably see it's all pretty cramped in here. As well as all the preset sounds and everything you've got, there's a couple of hundred kits on this thing. I'll show you those in a second. It's got I'm just having a giggle here. Preset songs, which are really, really naff. I'll just quickly put one on. Thank you. probably tell that doesn't get used much. Yeah. Okay, so there's the drum brain right there. You know, and it's still set on song. And I've got it, that was funk too. That execrable thing, whatever that was. Just pick back to, that's kit. And so change the kits and you go plus and minus and you pick a kit, you know, like that's bush brushes, groove. I was just playing groove. It's got a very, very, just looking at a stick there. Sharp sounding. So there's the, you know, there's the, that's the mesh head snare. It's a bit filthy actually. Should have cleaned it before doing this. Showing my horrible, horrible technique with my left hand. You know, yeah, you can't brush on it, but you can, you know, tap it very softly and then, you know, it's velocity controlled, like all these things are, you know, that's been in electronics forever. But it's a mesh sort of a head. It's springy. It's nice. They're very, very nice to play, these things. They feel a lot like a skin. These are the rubber pads. They feel like an old school, practice pad. And you can hear, when I roll these things rather rapidly, you can hear where the sort of where the sounds sort of cut off rather than carry into each other on like a real drum kit. So that kind of makes it sound more like sort of a bit synthy. You know, they've all got different strike zones on them. This, you know, there's three strike zones I think from memory. You know, on the maybe only two. Yeah, two I think on the synth. Different strike zones on the cymbals. I think there's only two in each of those. The hi-hats on this kit and on the preset kits, and even when I tweak them, the hi-hats on this thing are basically a disaster on the preset sounds. Because, you know, you can't really sort of get them up enough in the mix. They're not as distinctive the way they play as hi-hats are. They're okay. They do, you know, but I found using real kits, I can do a lot more with all hi-hats and get a lot more sort of sound out of them than I can out of this thing. I'm not sure what they're like on the high-end kits, to be honest. They look a bit fancier, but I'm not sure the functionality is any better. Something like the TD-20 drum brain. And some guys do have something, a more basic kit like this one, and actually buy the more expensive drum brain and put it in. And that can help because you get better sounds and there's a lot more you can do with it. It's more flexible. This thing, for what it is, though, it's pretty good. Does an alright job. I guess I should lead on to my favourite feature by far on this. Have a look here. There's two things here, and that says, phones and mix in. And I usually put my earphones in, usually, rather than have it through a sound system, so it disturbs nobody but me. Focus, your stupid camera. And mix in. And mix in's great, because then I can get my, focus, you stupid camera. My iPod. It's the one with a shattered screen. I'll just put that there. I'll use my iPhone. And I've got a cable somewhere. Male to male. And I, run out of that. Enter here. And I can play along with pretty much any song that I want to. Rather than the naff things on the drum brain. So, what have I got on there? Playing solitaire. People who know me know that I'm always playing solitaire when I'm on this thing. So let's say, for instance, try that again. So the good thing is I can basically jam with whoever I want to. If I want to jam with the Beatles, I can jam with the Beatles. But let's say I wanted to jam with Heart, say, Magic Man. Yeah, I can do that. And I'm going to do that for you in just a second. I'll probably completely cock it up, but, you know, I'll just do this for fun. Okay. Yeah, that's my general purpose kit. That's the one that I use on this. This has got heaps of kits on it. I'm not going to go through them all, but suffice it to say there's heaps. And there's all sorts of freaky sounds on this thing. So while I have got playing this song now, like I said, I can jam with whoever I wish, which is great. And quite often I like to jam with Heart because they're awesome. This is me jamming along with Magic Man, as I selected in the iPod before. I'm not note for note for this one, not even close. I just love to play along with it because it's a very groovy song. So ignore any mistakes.
Holy night, some ago, but I was not so strong. I will not be drunk to me.
Love that song. Gotta say, the ladies from Heart, and they're singing like that, it gives me a hard on. Can't say my playing does the same for them though. It's good fun though.